Hi, well, you okay, Sophie? Do you want to introduce yourself? And we'll begin.
Okay, my name is Sophie Ascough and I'm an artist and musician.
Brilliant, Sophie. Right, so to start off with, so let's get on with it. So what form does your art take? Visual, performing? What part of the arts are you into?
I'm kind of both in the music scene and being in bands, and I'm also at the moment an artist focusing mostly on sound art.
Right.
So I'm currently on an MA at Teesside Uni on fine art focusing on sound art,
Oh,
also
brilliant.
music.
Brilliant. Very clever girl.
Oh.
When did you first get involved in the arts anyway, in it all? Is it something that you've always been interested in or?
Yeah, I think so. I first got into music kind of in secondary school. I started learning guitar and everything. But I only really started doing kind of visual arts, fine art,
Right.
in maybe 2015. I didn't really know what I wanted to do after college. So I was like, I'll just try an art course.
Nice.
And I loved it. Absolutely loved it. So, but I've always been kind of interested in creative arts. But I got involved through a
So
foundation.
that's kind of answered my next question. What kind of inspired you then? It was well, it hasn't answered my next question, has it? It led into it. Sorry. And you could say what inspired you and who are your influences and your inspirations throughout. So you could like answer that question in a wanna,
Yeah.
really.
Should I talk about music as well?
Both, yeah,
Yeah.
obviously.
Getting involved in music was just seeing musicians. I kind of, when I was younger, I found out about the Runaways and I was like, oh, women. So that made me want to learn how to play guitar. So me and like a couple of my friends started doing bands in school, and that just kind of grew and grew. So that's one of my first influences for music was the Runaways, and then it kind of developed onto the Slits and then a lot of Riot Girl influences. But now my music taste is very broad as well. With art, yeah, it was just kind of not knowing what to do. And then I went to CCAD and did the foundation course.
Right.
And I was just kind of influenced by everyone who was there. So I would just kind of be throwing paint around. And then my influences grew when I went on to a BA and I started getting interested in sound art, video art. Tracy and the Plastics is a good influence. And yeah.
Brilliant, brilliant. So, were you self-taught? So, how did you sort of learn? You know, obviously, you went to college, but your guitar, did you pick that up yourself? Did you go to guitar lessons?
Yeah, I started having guitar lessons when I was young, but I never got good at it. Never. Never got good at guitar. So I'm a drummer now, so I'm kind of self-taught drums. I've got guitar lessons, but I don't use them. But I went to college. I went to like college, uni, MA for art. But I feel like with art, like you can't really be taught how to do it. And the way I make art's changed so drastically through studying. So like the software I use is self-taught through like YouTube
As they all are these days.
videos.
I mean, there's that much tutorial on there, isn't there? It's, you could be a
So good.
brain surgeon
I had to
tomorrow.
change a light bulb on my car and I was just like YouTube video, easy.
Yeah. So do you work, you just said you work alone or do you collaborate? You've been in bands, yeah, so
Yeah, with
do any solo singing?
yeah, with like music and bands, it's all about the collaboration. But with my solo stuff, because I work so like spontaneously, I couldn't really explain to someone what on earth I'm trying to do, because I can't even explain it to myself. I just kind of try and whatever happens. So I've got some solo stuff that I do, and then collaboratively is the band.
Your band. So where would you normally perform? I mean, I know you've performed in
One
Disgraceland, and I hope we're going to have you performing in Disgraceland again.
of my favorite gigs. Yeah,
Was very hot. What a stage. Anyway, so go on. So where would you normally perform? Like local, I know you go on tour, don't you, and stuff with your band and that.
Yeah, like little ones. We try and go up and down the country. We wanted to do some like other things, but obviously lockdown's just kind of smashed everything. But we do like playing locally. We kind of started out playing in Newcastle. I think our first gig was a Star and Shadow. I love it there. We haven't played there in a while, but I really like local venues, DIY venues as well.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
My favourite. And also like presenting art as well. I like kind of local DIY art spaces a lot.
But you've been involved with Picasso Baby as well, haven't you? Yourself doing your art as well, yeah.
That's so fun. Me and Danielle, yeah. And the singer. Yeah.
It's all still there. It's all still there.
And that was so fun.
Well, hopefully, we won't be long, we'll be up and running again. So why do you think that the creative arts are important to you and in general in society?
To me, I just have to do it. Like, I get so angry if I don't have a gig coming up. I get so, like, antsy. But I think it must be some sort of very cliche release. But a cliche again, yeah, people have to be able to express themselves, and people just sometimes have to make something, and it doesn't even have to be good. Like, a lot of the stuff I make isn't good. I just have to do it. And
really,
I think
that's what you mean by good.
I know. I don't that's even think,
you know what I mean?
Yeah. Doing these things can be good. It's just trying to get something to happen.
How has the lockdown, do you think, affected you with your creativity? Do you think it's had a bit of a, have you gone on the low down, or have you got creative while you've been during the lockdown? Or, like you say, you get angsty when you don't have a gig. So
yeah.
How's the whole thing affected you then and your future plans?
I kind of wish it had, like, I wish I had just harnessed all of this time to do something. But I think art is very, like, for me at least, like, mental health related.
Yeah.
So I've kind of had a creative block. But I'm lucky that my sound art at the moment I can kind of do at home if I have the energy. So for me, it hasn't really affected the way I can work, except for obviously not being able to see any of my band, not being able to do the gig, not being able to hang out in Disgraceland.
Won't be long.
But yeah, I've not been making very much work. I still have a master's to finish, so I mean, hopefully I can make something work.
I must admit, the whole lockdown for me, flat.
Yeah.
I've just flattened out. A lot of people, I could see on Facebook and things, you know, people are, you know, being, you know, this is like giving me a lot of time to think and this and the other. And it did, but really in a negative way, because all I've done is like being really flat and unfocused about anything. Feel a bit better now. A bit of interaction is good, isn't it? Sort of seeing
things.
It's good. I've enjoyed doing this, enjoyed chatting, but I'm with you there. The mind's just gone down. So hopefully, and when I'm interviewing the other girls in the band as well. So, you know, yeah. We'll all have a get together afterwards. It's just been a way of time, hasn't it, really? Something that I didn't see in my lifetime.
You realise how important just the social aspect of it all is, isn't it?
Yeah, it's just been so strange. But it's been absolutely lovely to see your face. And you look beautiful, by the way. I'm looking at myself thinking, oh, my lockdown hair.
Makeup in so long, I was trying to do my eyeliner, like, oh.
Well, have you got anything else you want to end with? Anything you'd like to say or about stuff? About your own?
I do, like, I have a band camp where I kind of just chuck all of my solo things.
Right.
But I don't really know if I want to link people to it, because it's a bit of a mess.
Right, well, we'll end on that one then, Sophie.
Okay.
Have you enjoyed, have I been okay interviewing?
Yeah, you're fab. I hope I haven't, like, rambled too incoherently.
Like Piers Morgan and jump on you. No, though, well, I've enjoyed speaking to you, Sophie. Like I say, I'll be talking to the other girls. We haven't hooked up yet, but they're going to do it.
Yeah.
And, like I say, this will all be collated together, and then you can be able to watch it.
Oh, God.